I don't approach people with negativity. I react. If you come at me nice and sweet, you're gonna get nice and sweet. You come at me with some trash, you're gonna get some trash.
Here's the thing. When someone is in camp screaming and yelling at other people constantly about everything, that puts everyone in a bad mood.
Who have I screamed and yelled at, Jason?
You've yelled at Ashley, you've yelled at Marissa, you yelled at one of our guests who came. Anybody who asks you a question or tries to do something on their own, you constantly correct them and tell them they're doing it wrong.
That's not true.
It's absolutely true.
Is that true?
100%
true. When you ask me to do things?
Amazing how you always try to go to someone that you think is weak. That's what bullies do. You yell at every single girl.
I'm not a bully. You're a baby,
dude. Don't ask her.
You have these little temper tantrums after every challenge. You're like, oh, I don't want to be on the team.
Oh, my God, I'm an outlaw. I'm a renegade, but they splashed me in the face. I can't tackle anyone now. Sorry, I got splashed.
Okay,
who are you trying to kid?
I'm not trying to kid anybody.
Natalie, what's it like being in the middle of this?
I just kind of leaning back just in case fists go flying, because I don't want it to be me getting hit.
Russell, you're a guy that likes to get scrappy. Explain to me what's going on between Ben and Jason.
I think that it's just Ben said some negative things that might have been racial.
Yeah, they might have been racial. Okay.
And it affected the way Jason thought about him, and that was it. That was the end of the relationship.
Jason, you guys still have a chance in this game. You're down 4 after tonight, but you're not out. Is there any way you could heal this wound?
I just have to draw a line in the sand. And I have to say that, you know, there is no $1 million that is worth me sitting up here with him anymore. I mean, I sat here and watched him scream it at Yasmin at our camp and over here saying incredible things. So is there a way to patch this rift? I don't think so. But I'm not going to sit in camp and listen to this guy anymore. I'm just not.
Ben, big reaction from him.
I have said from the get-go, everybody knows I've been very, very consistent. I have not started one fight. Not started one.
That's not even what I was talking about. I was talking more about the ghetto trash that you tried to call her over
Okay,
there.
Well, she's from the ghetto and she's trashy. That's ghetto trash. I'm sorry. Like, that's not racial whatsoever. That's okay. Where you're from and how you're acting.
If that's really what you think, Ben.
So if you can't understand
let me make another point then. Southern guy with Southern ways. Do you really think you should talk to a woman that way?
You know what?
Southern,
if she's gonna be disrespectful.
Do you speak to a young lady that way?
She's not a lady.
Really? She wasn't a lady? I mean, come on.
Ladies have manners, okay? This girl right here, Southern, has manners. Says yes, sir, yes, ma'am, please, thank you.
Okay.
So Yasmin's being a bitch, then she's not a lady. I mean, it's not that hard.
Okay.
There was nothing racial that I said.
Whatever.
It was strictly what I saw.
You say so.
How she was acting towards me. So if you wanna call it a racial game and play that card, then go for it, buddy.
You know, you should have some sensitivity to history. And historically, when certain comments are made and directed towards certain people, it is because of race. I mean, if what you're telling me is that what you said had absolutely no racial context, then maybe Yasmin was right and you are ignorant. Maybe you really don't get it.